The next paper is Quality of Life in Elderly in Rural Sri Lanka, a large community-based cross-sectional study. The paper is from Vikramasinghe, Pereira and Agampodi, and Vikramasinghe would be presenting.
Chairperson, panel of judges, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to you all. Our study is Quality of Life in Elderly in Rural Sri Lanka, a large community-based cross-sectional study. Sri Lanka has the fastest aging population in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka has one of the fastest aging populations in South Asia, with 15% of Sri Lankan population is over 60 years of age. And further, it is estimated that 1 in 4 Sri Lankans will be elderly by the year 2041. However, even with this increase, community-based studies assessing the quality of life in elderly is scarce. With this background, the aim of this study was to assess the quality of life among the elderly in a rural Sri Lankan setting. We conducted a community-based cross-sectional study in Talawa Divisional Secretariat area, and the sample consisted of 3,652 elderly people aged 60 to 74 years selected by convenient sampling. We used a validated single version of the Quality of Life instrument for the young elderly in Sri Lanka, which assessed 6 domains of quality of life, namely physical, psychological, social, functional, environmental and spiritual. 10 trained Ayurvedic health promotion officers collected data. Data analysis was conducted by using SPSS version 25, and scoring of the tool was done according to the original guidelines, and all scores were transformed to present in a scale from 0 to 100. Mean and the SD values for each domain of quality of life was developed. An independent t-test for subgroup analysis was done for all 6 domain scores. The final sample consisted of 3,573 participants with a response rate of almost 98%. The majority of the sample, that is about 60%, were females. The mean age was 66.7 years, and most of the participants have completed their primary education. 3/4 of the sample had at least one diagnosed chronic disease at the time of study. With regard to the mean scores of quality of life domains, all 6 quality of life domains had a mean score more than 50. The lowest score was recorded for the physical quality of life domain with a mean score of 52.9, while the highest was recorded for the functional quality of life domain with a mean of 63.4. Almost all quality of life domains except for physical quality of life domain had a mean score approximately to 60. With regard to the subgroup analysis, male participants have recorded high mean scores for all 6 quality of life domains. However, only physical, psychological, and social quality of life domains had a statistically significant higher score than females. With regard to the marital status, the participants who were married at the time of the study and living with their spouse, they have reported high scores for all 6 domains, which were statistically significant. The participants who have educated at least up to grade 6 or above, they have reported higher mean scores for all 6 domains. Again, all these 6 domains were statistically significant. Similarly, the participants who haven't had any reported and diagnosed chronic disease reported statistically higher mean scores for all 6 domains of quality of life. So, this large community-based study has revealed that quality of life in rural elderly is relatively high. Males not having any chronic diseases, high education level, and being married and living with the spouse were found to be statistically significant factors which is associated with higher quality of life. These findings are inconsistent with the previous literature, where they say that having immediate social level, social support, and having good social relationships, being active, having no functional limitations, as well as possible better understanding and awareness of changes in elderly life could lead to better quality of life in elderly. However, more comparative studies across different study settings to identify unique issues pertinent to elderly, and also qualitative studies to identify possible reasons and associations for better quality of life are needed to develop context-specific programs to improve quality of life in elderly in Sri Lanka. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
So quite a few of the associations you found are minimally modifiable or non-modifiable. But is there anything that maybe any data that you didn't have time to present where you could, what would your preliminary suggestions be on improving the quality of life?
Thank you very much for that very interesting question. What we found was, with informal discussions we have had with these elderly, now we live in an era where we try to promote healthy aging, and also the concept of a salutogenic approach to health is promoted. Therefore, as the second phase of this study, actually we mapped community-based health assets in that particular area. We have not done individual level correlation with association with health assets in the particular area, but it seems that in villages where they have a lot of opportunities for social interactions, the quality of life reported in correlation level data analysis is more. Therefore, what we promote in our country also, to provide them more opportunities to liaise with other people in the community and to give more opportunities for them for active aging, rather than being isolated and rather than being neglected. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And thank you very much for that paper.